Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome you as we gather to lift up our praises and our prayers to our wonderful God. Reminder that this evening at 7 we will have our voters assembly meeting, and we offer a special welcome to Stephen, who's able to be back with us again today. We'll continue with our opening hymn, number 405, To Jordan's River King, Our Lord. Let us then confess our sins to God, our Father.
Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and
Almighty God in his mercy has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are gathered this day to worship our triune God and to focus our attention on baptism. Let us join in singing. solemn promises and vows of holy baptism. Do you renounce the devil and all his works and all his ways?
I do renounce them.
Do you believe in God the Father?
Yes, I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son?
Yes, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead.
He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
Yes, I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
We join as we offer up our prayer in him.
The same way, count yourselves dead to sin
confessing their sins, they were baptized by him in the Jordan River. John wore clothing made of camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. And this was his message: after me will come one more powerful than I, the thongs of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. At that time, Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. As Jesus was coming up out of the water, he saw heaven being torn open and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven: you are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We join in singing our hymn, Jesus Once Was Sinners, number 444. Please be seated.
Thank you.
sisters and brothers, Christ Jesus, our Savior, our Lord, our Redeemer. The past 12 months have been a traumatic time for our world, and especially our nation. From COVID-19 to riots and unrest in so many of our nation's larger cities, to a contentious election, to the most recent rampage in our nation's capital. Yet, this morning, I encourage you not to dwell upon all this and become stuck in thinking about all these events. For I remind you, as President Hagen pointed out in a note that he sent out to pastors yesterday, our primary identity is not as a father or mother, husband or wife, young or old, Republican or Democrat, but as a child of God. Thanks be to God that Jesus was numbered with sinners in his baptism, so that we might be numbered with him in eternity. Christ's mission was not to establish an earthly kingdom, but an eternal kingdom. Many people are discouraged about what is going on in our nation. This is precisely why we need to keep the focus on Christ. Indeed, we preach Christ crucified and celebrate that we are children of God. One of the greatest ways that we learn as children, no matter what age, is by learning the fundamentals. The fundamentals of counting and language, 1, 2, 3s and ABCs. The fundamentals of social behavior, how to stand in line and wait your turn, and sharing toys in the sandbox. But most important of all are the fundamentals of the Christian faith. Our sin and our Savior, Jesus. Creation, fall, redemption. The Ten Commandments, the Apostles' Creed, the Lord's Prayer, baptism, confession and absolution, and the Lord's Supper. This echoes a poster that can be found in various classrooms. Everything I need to know I learned in preschool. We learn the Christian faith in a similar way. Lutherans use the small catechism. There's no better summary of the Christian faith for teaching God's children, again, no matter what the age, the fundamental teachings of Scripture, the Ten Commandments, the Apostles' Creed, the Lord's Prayer, baptism, confession and absolution, the Lord's Supper. We could make our own poster. Everything I need to know, I learned in catechism class. Now, that doesn't mean you stop learning and growing in the Christian faith, or that everything outside of the catechism is unimportant. No, there's no graduation from the catechism. You don't receive a diploma when you're confirmed. Rather, in the fundamental teachings of the Scriptures, we have a firm foundation upon which everything is built. So today, as we celebrate baptism, Jesus' baptism and our own, we, in a way, are going to go back to school. As we celebrate Jesus' baptism, we will also celebrate and rejoice in our baptism. I invite you now to open your bulletin to the
preach. And as we do so, we begin with that first basic question of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther. What is baptism?
Baptism is not just plain water, but it is the water included in God's command and combined with God's Word.
Which is that Word of God?
Christ our Lord
says in the last chapter of Matthew, therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
When we wash, we use soap and water. But a minute later, our hands can already be dirty. It's an imperfect, but it's a good reflection of our sin. Like Lady Macbeth, no matter how many times we try to wash away our sin on our own, we can't wash out that damned spot. But when God washes us in baptism with water and His Word, you have a sure promise. God's Word washes your sin, which damns you, away. It is gone. The Apostle Peter proclaimed this very thing in Acts 2. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. This promise is for you and for your children and for all who are far off, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to Himself. Baptism forgives your sins. Baptism gives you the Holy Spirit. Baptism is for all children of God, no matter what age. Scripture teaches us all are conceived and born in sin and are under the devil's power until Jesus claims them as His very own. We need a new birth, as Jesus told Nicodemus. I tell you the truth, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Jesus gives us the new birth we need in holy baptism. In baptism, you are born from above, a new birth by the water and the Holy Spirit. You're made God's own dear child. Baptism is your second birthday, when you're born into heaven. This is why Jesus was baptized in the Jordan River. Though Jesus had no sin to wash away, He stood in that water for you. The evangelist Matthew says it was to fulfill all righteousness. Jesus chose to receive a sinner's baptism to be water for you, or to be baptized with sinners, and to be baptized for sinners. Although He is sinless, He is baptized to bear our sin and carry it all the way to the cross. So we continue with the second basic question of Dr. Martin Luther. What benefits does baptism give? It works in forgiveness of sins, rescues from death and the devil, and gives eternal salvation to all who believe this, as the words and promises of God declare. Which are these words and promises of God? Christ our Lord says in the last chapter of Mark, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned.
provide for their needs, as God calls us to as parents. So why not give them the best gift God has given us? Baptism. For if we lovingly care for our children, how much more does our Heavenly Father care for each and every one of you? This is how Jesus loves us. He puts himself there into the waters of the Jordan so that he can put himself and put upon himself and us that sin, and put himself there so that we can be baptized. Of all places to find theological truth, Carrie Underwood stated in one of her songs, "Felt love pouring down from above, got washed in the water, washed in the blood, and now I'm changed, and now I'm stronger. There must have been something in the water." Indeed, there is something in the water of baptism. The Word of God, which promises baptism now saves you. Not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pledge of a good conscience toward God. It saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ. The same Word declares there's not only the something of God's Word in the water, there's also someone in the water. Paul tells us, "You are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus. For all of you who were baptized into Christ have clothed yourselves with Christ." So, we consider our third basic question offered by the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther. How can water do such great things? Certainly not just water, but the Word of God in and with the water does these things, along with the faith which trusts this Word of God in the water. For without God's Word, the water is plain water and no baptism. But with the Word of God, it is a baptism. That is, life-giving water, rich in grace, and a washing of the new birth in the Holy Spirit, as St. Paul says in Titus chapter 3. He saved us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us generously through Jesus Christ our Savior, so that having been justified by his grace, we might become heirs having the hope of eternal life. This is a trustworthy saying. At every baptism, the Lord of all is in the water to give all of himself to you. He who made the heavens and the earth remakes you as a new creation. Since you've been washed, you are now Jesus' bride, the church. Jesus sacrificed himself on that cross so that he might make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the Word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. So we ask our final basic question. What does such washing with water indicate? It indicates that the old Adam in us should by daily contrition and repentance be drowned and die with all sins and every evil desire, and that a new man should daily emerge and arise to live before God in righteousness and purity forever. Where is this written? St. Paul writes in Romans chapter 6, "We were therefore
because Jesus crucified and risen is the someone in the water, and the something of his word is also present, something else is also in the water. You are. The Holy Spirit descends on you. Heaven is opened to you. You're given hope in one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of us all. He declares his blessing upon you. You are my sons and daughters whom I love. With you, I am well pleased. When it comes to Jesus' baptism and yours, there truly is something in the water for you. The very word of Jesus. And there's someone in that water for you. Your Savior. This is most certainly true. Amen. Now may the peace and the love of our God that pass beyond our understanding guard and protect our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Savior. Amen. Turn to hymn 596, All Christians Who Have Been Baptized.
join together in prayer, I invite those who are able to please stand.
O Lord, created in your image, formed for your glory, called by your name, and washed clean in baptism, we come this day as the people of your promise, with the intercessions and prayers for all people, as they have need. Heavenly Father, you have revealed your Son to us in the wondrous epiphany in the Jordan. So also you have revealed your name and blessing to us in holy baptism, declaring us your beloved children and heirs. Grant that we may daily die to sin and rise to newness of life, living with joy as your baptized children. Preserve your holy church here and scattered throughout the world. Give steadfast faith to all Christians by the preaching of your word and through your sacraments, and send laborers into your harvest. Encourage the love of your saints to bear one another's burdens and to show mercy toward those outside of the church. Enliven us in the hope of eternal life in Christ Jesus. O Lord, we thank you and rejoice that we now count ourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Heavenly Father, you manifested yourself with the Holy Spirit in the fullness of grace at the baptism of your beloved Son, and with your voice directed us to him who has carried our sins, so we might receive grace and the forgiveness of sins. Preserve us from impenitence and unbelief. Cleanse us from our unrighteousness, and clothe us with the righteousness purchased with your Son's blood. Keep us in the true faith, since we have been baptized in accordance with your command and the example of your dear Son. Strengthen our faith by your Holy Spirit, and lead us to everlasting life and salvation. O Lord, we thank you and rejoice that we now count ourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Heavenly Father, preserve the family, especially all Christian homes. Turn husband and wife toward one another in love. Equip husband, or fathers and mothers for their holy duty as teachers of the faith. And preserve all children in the saving faith and certain promises of their baptism to life everlasting. We offer you thanks for the blessings that you have given to Orville and Nora during their wedded life. Continue to bless them and all couples, that they may live in union with one another and seek to do all to your glory. O Lord, we thank you and rejoice that we now count ourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Heavenly Father, you have given us this good land as our heritage. Grant that we remember your generosity and constantly do your will. Bless our land with honest industry, truthful education, and honorable way of life. Save us from violence, discord, and confusion, from pride and arrogance and every evil course of action, especially as it has been too evident in our nation in the past year. Grant that we, who came from many nations with many different languages, may become a united people. Support us in defending our liberties. Give those to whom we have entrusted the authority of government the spirit of wisdom, that there may be justice and peace in our land. When times are prosperous, may our hearts be thankful. And in troubled times, do not let our trust in you fail. O Lord, we thank you and rejoice that we now count ourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Heavenly Father, give comfort and relief to those who are sick, depressed, tired, confused, or in any need, including John, Debbie, Brad, Marcus, Paul, Mike, Glenn, Lois, Claude, Stephen, Bonnie,
David, Helen, Jimmy, Carol, Bill, Shirley, Eldon, Ken, David, Ron, Larry, Terry, Joy, all who are dealing with recovery from winter storms and violence, all affected by the ongoing pandemic and its effects, including the residents and staff of the Lutheran Home, and those having to deal with quarantine, those we now lift to you in our hearts. Watch over all expectant mothers and their children, that they may have a safe delivery and be brought also to the life-giving waters of holy baptism and your name. Be with those who are near death, that they may hear your Son's words of grace in their last hour and be confident in their baptism, where you named them to be your child. O Lord, we thank you and rejoice that we now count ourselves dead to sin,
but alive to God in Christ Jesus.
Heavenly Father, we remember with thanksgiving all who went before us with the sign of faith, who passed on to us the sign of faith, and who now rest in Jesus from all their labors, including Reverend Jack Gillum. Preserve us in the same faith and hope until that day when we delight to stand with them around the throne of Jesus, the Lamb who was slain, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit. Keep us faithful to the baptismal covenant in which we died with Jesus, so we may be raised with him in perfect freedom to life everlasting. Only all to you. O Lord, we thank you and rejoice that we now count ourselves dead to sin,
but alive to God in Christ Jesus.
Having been crucified with Christ and anointed with the Spirit in holy baptism, we approach your throne, Heavenly Father, in confidence and trust, laying our prayers and petitions before you, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Since we are your dear children and you are our Father, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
Our closing hymn is number 922, Go, My Children, with My Blood.